N55 owners out there, is your BMW telling you that your water pump is missing? Well, we're going to explain to you why that is on this FCP Euro Tech Tip. So listen, hypothetically, I'm not saying this happened to me, but I'm also not saying it didn't happen to me. Maybe I'm driving up to Stowe, Vermont in mid-December. Maybe I'm somewhere around White River Junction trying to merge onto a highway. Maybe my car goes into limp mode, says it's overheating. And maybe I have a scanner with me and it tells me I have a CD9010 LIN bus communication fault and the water pump is missing. Maybe that happened to me, maybe it's happened to you. But is the water pump actually missing? The answer is no, it's there. The problem is your DME doesn't know it's there. And the reason for that is the aluminum screw that holds the water pump ground to the bed plate in the engine block has mysteriously broken off. This only seems to be an issue on N55s because this water pump ground is used for N52s and N54s, but this seems to affect N55s only. I don't know why that is. Could be a material problem with the screw, could be a harmonics problem. Maybe they weren't torqued properly from the factory and the screw loosens up over time. Either way, there's no need to use the aluminum screw in this application because it is an aluminum block. Use a zinc plated steel screw, put some blue Loctite on it. The screw is not what creates the ground, it's the ring terminal against the engine block that creates the ground. So in this car's case, which is a 2013 135, it still has that factory ground screw in there. We're just gonna remove it preemptively and we're gonna replace it with a steel screw and torque it so that this never ends up being a problem again. So the CD9010 fault code is a communication problem. And this ground right here is for the water pump. You can actually trace the wire back to the connector. This aluminum screw right here from the factory, the head of it will break off. Now, this is attached to the bed plate of the engine, and you'll also notice that there's another hole above it. We'll talk about that in a second. But if this screw were to break off, this ground will come off, and then you lose water pump communication. The only exception to that would be an N55 that uses a water pump that has a solid mounting to the engine block instead of rubber isolators. In that case, sometimes a water pump can somehow ground itself back through the engine block, but it is a good idea to always have this screw attached or this ground attached with a screw. And even though this has not failed yet, there's no need to take this chance. So we're gonna take that screw off and replace it with a traditional steel screw. And the other thing is that other hole above, if the remnants of that screw are broken off and it's still, you can't get it out of that lower hole, you could always utilize that one above. It's threaded and it has the same depth exactly as that lower one. So worst case scenario, you can always move the ground up if you needed to. So the screw is an E12 Torx. And that was actually kind of loose, I'm not gonna lie. Didn't really take much to break that away. Now it's actually getting a little more difficult as it comes out, but I think that's just the junk that's up there. And that right there is our factory screw. It does have this big washer on it, but the threaded portion is 20 millimeters. We don't necessarily need that big washer, but that is the problem. And usually what happens when this breaks, it shears off right at the head, which says to me it's some kind of fatigue failure, like it may have loosened up and then it just broke off over time. That little retaining clip that fell out, that just holds onto the ground wire and also prevents it from rotating as you torque the ground bolt down. New bolt is just a zinc coated M8x20 bolt. And then put a little bit of blue Loctite on it to make sure that it can't back out. And now we just thread this in. Now, you might be questioning, is it safe to use a steel bolt in this engine block? And the answer is yes, it's just an aluminum engine block. You wouldn't be able to do this on an N52 engine because of the magnesium content, but for the N55, which is just a standard aluminum block, you don't need to do anything special with it. And it's also not the bolt that creates the ground. It is the contact of that ring terminal up against the block that creates the ground. And for the steel M8 bolt, we're just gonna torque it to a standard torque spec, which is 23 newton meters. And there you go. You now have a permanently affixed ground screw to your engine block. You don't have to worry about that CD9010 LIN bus communication fault where your car believes that the water pump is now MIA, even though it's still there. So that's the fix. kind of a silly problem, but this only seems to be an issue on the N55 engine. If you have an N54, you can also do the steel ground screw trick. On the N52, you'll have to use the factory aluminum screw because that is an aluminum and magnesium engine block, and the magnesium content will cause a corrosion problem with the steel screw, but that's not the issue for the aluminum block engines. So, hope you learned something in this video. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment box below. Let us know if it happened to you. We also have the blog article we wrote about this linked in the description. If you like this video, hit the like button. We have a lot of content on the way, as always, so hit that subscribe button. As always, we'll see you for the next one. Thanks for watching.